Hello everyone, my name is Brian and welcome to another Smite commentary. And this time it is Ymir in Clash. And we are going to do something a little bit different. This is something I've actually gotten from someone else, from Mythimu. He's also a Smite YouTuber. A very big one, the biggest one actually. He makes a lot of fun content, so if you haven't checked him out just yet, definitely do, because he does make fun content. It's a lot different than mine, but I really enjoy his videos as well. So what he has done was an Ymir build which had only HP items. So that's something I'm going to do. Well, I'm not going, a little spoiler, I'm not going to do full HP, but I'm definitely taking a lot of HP. One of which, wow, what? Okay, that Ever died is lagging. Wow. Okay. Odd start already. But I'm getting a lot of HP. This is also the time I'm going to get the achievement for more than 4000 HP on a Guardian or a Warrior. So I haven't really tried it out. Ymir is the best one for that, by the way, because he has the highest HP and highest HP per level. As you can see, I'm level 3 and I already have about 1k HP, which is definitely a lot. Definitely an awful lot. So I'll start off with a Warlock Sash. Because it's an item that you have to stack up, it's usually better to get it early as possible. And since I'm in Ymir, I'm not too afraid to die. Doesn't mean that I can't die because I have more HP. But I feel like that with the new amount of HP, my chance of survival is just very high. Let's see. They do have a decent team. And if you look at the Nemesis and the Ao Quang, those are both actually kind of a downside of, well, me going for that HP build. Because Ao Quang usually builds Soul Reaver, which does percentage true damage. The ultimate of Nemesis also does true damage. Ah, it was too late. I wanted to catch that dash. Nice. At least we pick up Ao Quang for the even trade. But what I was trying to say is, Nemesis ultimate also does a percentage of your current health. So the more health I have, the more, the more damage I take, which makes sense. And also the execute from Ao Quang also is percentage based, I think 30%, which is in my case, if I have like 4000 HP, that is still about 1200 HP, which you can execute. I mean, that is definitely difficult to deal with. I don't have any mana. I kind of want to stay a bit. Wow, nice pull. That was an impressive pull by the Sylvanas. Well done. Not enough to finish it off though, but yeah. I do want to stick around for this gold a little bit. Once I have it, I can just back, like I'm doing now. Get that Warlock Sash, get that stacks going, get a little bit more mana, which is definitely something I can use, because I was out of mana as well. And now I'm going for Winged Blade. So, even though I don't get boots because they don't provide health or much health, I can definitely go for Winged Blade and another movement speed item. Ritual Dagger is an option, provides 200 HP and 10% movement speed. As well as, if you look at Rod of the Sleepiest, does the same thing, also provides a lot of that. Ah, it looks like our Rama has died because of the wisps from the Sylvanas, or maybe the Sylvanas ultimate bleed. That's also an option. Come on, can we at least get the Ao Quang? Doesn't look like we can. That sucks. No kills in return. Two of ours. Oh, I can be picked up here as well. Oh, never mind. He got killed by the minions. Went a little bit too aggressive. I'm just going to stay in the heal for a bit. I do need to be careful. He can just execute me if he plays it well. But that wall will deter him from going for me, but damn, there's a lot of fighting going on already. And that's something I actually don't like as much, because I don't have any movement speed just yet. I think that the further this game goes, the more items I get, I will be a lot stronger. And if I get a Rod of Asclepius and a Winged Blade, I have more movement speed than I would have gotten from just boots. And I will also get HP from all those items. And Rod of Asclepius will also help out with the healing department. Which in this case, since I'm getting Stone of Gaia, which heals percentage of your HP over time, is also very good for me. And if Rod doesn't pick it up, then it's also good for the entire team because, well, Ra is a healer. Can we heal some damage? Come on. Ah, well, maybe Ram can pick it up. Come on. One more shot. Ah, that's unfortunate. But that is an Aphrodite ultimate, so that gives us a small window of opportunity to kill her, so to speak. Although, it's never too easy to kill her, unless, of course, she's staying a bit too close. Oh, nice pull by the Savannah. Just barely not a tower, which is important. Come on, can I get it in between? Not good enough. Looks like he is going to be picked up. But a killer return. He was still inside my range. The teleport isn't that long, so I knew he was still inside. But he also was revealed by maybe the minions or a teammate. I'm not sure. Beautiful snipe by the Ra. Will secure kill on Aphrodite. And that will be 5 and 6. Not too bad, to be honest. And I will have my Winged Blade now. So, there are a couple of options. You can go for an E-Staff. E-Staff provides you, I think, 300 health. Which is definitely very good. Because it also converts a portion of your HP to power. I think 3%, if I'm not mistaken. So, if I go for 4000 HP... that means that I will have 120 additional power. I didn't miss everything, but the wall was still fine because it could blocked the nemesis from getting out of the tower range quick enough. But that's fine. The Haboa is glad with it though. I rotated. I tried to help. Missed everything, but it's fine. Oh man. It would have been a lot better if I just hit that stun. It could have killed the nemesis. Maybe, but in that case, it might actually been the case that I was not able to pick up the nemesis. Or we weren't able. Because if I stun her and don't kill her immediately, she will either use her shield or she will just run away immediately without chasing in the tower range. So that's also an interesting one. Kind of want to prevent Sylvanas from rotating, but that's a lot of damage with the ultimates. Doesn't look like I do a lot of damage though. The cat's definitely hurting, but it's not going to... oh, actually it is enough. The cat's lasted long enough just before our Bastet died. We were... oh, I suck. That sucks. That little dash just barely came out before I used my wall. Preventing her... well, she actually was able to get away with that. So, I guess well played. If I was just a fraction of a second earlier, then I would have caught her dash. Which... resulted in her death guaranteed. This time it actually resulted in her getting away. Maybe she would have been caught if I didn't use a wall at all. Not sure. We won't find out, so I guess we can just better move on. Try to assist in any way we can. And not try to wall enemies off when we kind of want to kill them. Also, they have double healer Sylvanas as well as the Aphrodite, so... that's also one of the reasons I'm not going for full HP, because if we don't get any healing reduction, we will never ever be able to win this match. Need to kind of wiggle my way out of this one. Ah, oh, beautiful route. Come on. Come on. No wisps. Ooh, 8 HP. This is definitely the time to run. Come on. Blocking off with the wall. At least Rama is safe and I'm as well, but Ra is definitely not getting out of that one. A huge dive by the enemies. That makes sense. They picked up two of us. The Haboa as well as the Bastet were both picked up. And from there out, yeah. That sucks. They have a lot of sustain. They have insane sustain. I'm getting the Divine Rune probably a little bit too late, to be honest. I'm letting my team know we need some anti-heal though. Because dealing with an Aphrodite as well as a Sylvanas is just a little bit too much healing if you ask me. Let's just go for that ultimate. Secure that Gold Fury if necessary. A bit too early on. If I used it a little bit later, that would have been better. Because, of course, I would have had the killing blow on the Gold Fury. But I'd rather do it this way than risking the enemy coming in, swooping in at the last moment and stealing it with, I don't know, Roma Invicta or just a basic attack. Talking about Roma Invicta, used by the Bologna, blocking off the Aphrodite, and that will be the kill on Aphrodite. Took some tower shots, she was stunned inside, and that wall blocked her off beautifully. So, definitely good for us. My cooldowns are quite long though, I don't have any cooldown reduction with this build. Which is kind of, well, I guess that's the downside of going for a lot of HP, but I already have 2500 HP. That's more HP than, well, most. Come on, can we save the Abwa? No, that's unfortunate. I think he got hit by a Polynomicon basic attack, but he used his escape, so that will be a kill. And I'm not going to use another basic attack. That one definitely belonged to the Bastet, and she can use it. So, I guess it's fine. I also have a couple of kills already, and I've been part of almost every single kill on the team already, so I'm fine. Don't worry about me, I'm fine. So, okay, I can't go for a tower push. Not really feeling like it though. I'll just get the back camps, and after that get some items online. Getting that E-Staff will actually provide me a lot of power. Like I mentioned, if I have 4k HP, it provides me 120 power. Which is not bad, because that's just the passive, and also provides the 30 power. It's actually 400 HP, so that's a very good amount of health as well. And as you can see, almost at 3000 HP with just 3 items finished. And my Warlock stash isn't even stacked up that much, it's only 45 stacks out of the 100. So definitely a lot of HP possible to go. Come on, can I blink in? Oh, I didn't stun the one I wanted to stun. And we are in kind of a rough spot. Oh no, that sucks. Got pulled. If I was a little bit sooner, I think it would actually have saved her. Come on. I'm trying to move as fast as I can. That sucks. Ultimate use by Aphrodite, so that's kind of a win, I guess. One of the only wins I had. That sucks. That is very unfortunate. Bit too much damage. That looks pretty beautiful, actually. Come on. Can we at least try to get the Aphrodite? No, she has Sanctuary, why? Okay, that's at least a kill. We do need to be a little bit, well, not too careful though. Wall in your face. Ah, oh, Sylvanas is around. Never mind, not going to chase any further. Yeah, let's just get that Rod of Asclepius. Not so much for the additional healing just yet, because I don't have any Stone of Gaia or other healing items. You can also go for a, oh, what is it called? Also one of those items I don't pick up that often, but it gives you regeneration for HP as well as health once you sidestepped and Ra got pulled and he got aggro. I'm so sorry, Ra. He did survive, but damn, he took, oh, never mind. I jinxed it. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm so sorry. If I didn't juke it, I think it would have been fine, but I juked out the Sylvanas. I'm so sorry. Come on, can we get the Sylvanas? I don't have enough damage, he heals too much. Ah, oh, that sucks. But, yeah, not so much for the healing. Midgardian Mail, that wasn't. No, that wasn't it. Never mind. If I come up with the name, I'll let you know. But, for now, the additional movement speed is what I'm after, so... It also provides a decent amount of health, 200, and some power, 75 if I'm not mistaken in total. So it provides me a good amount of power because I feel like we lack the burst to kind of kill someone. That's one of the main reasons. Come on. Oh, I can't chase off. He's too quick. That sucks. That sucks. Come on. Aphrodite! Damn it. She has her ultimate. But it blocks her for a very long time, and it will secure the kill with the bleed from the Bastet. Definitely a good one. Nice ultimate by the Aphrodite. Maybe I should have popped my ultimate sooner to try and prevent that if she had it in case of. I actually didn't expect her to have her ultimate after all those fights, but I guess she either has a lot of cooldown reduction, which makes sense, or she just wasn't forced into it, which is probably the most unfortunate thing. Come on. A lot of damage. Purification beats forced. Nice try on the Ra snipe. He actually would have gotten it if he didn't use purification beats. So I guess the purification beats didn't go to waste on his side. Without it, he probably would have died because my two would have connected, as well as the Ra snipe. Would have been a cap. I'm going for a Stone of Gaia next. That's the probably the HP item to round it off with, because it provides me 400 HP. It provides me health over time. I think 2% of my HP each 5 seconds, if I'm not mistaken. That's a lot, to be honest, because yeah, that is like, I don't know, 80 HP every 5 seconds. That's not too bad. It's not insane, to be honest, but it's also not too bad. But with Brothers of Sleepius, I also get a little bit more healing from that one, and I have a lot of HP, so getting me low requires a lot for the enemy, and I can heal up pretty easily with my nice ultimate force by the Aphrodite, and I'm going to close her in. Ah, she has Sanctuary. That sucks so much. Also, an additional effect that helps me a lot in this game with Winged Blade, and that's also the reason why I took it, to be honest. Besides the point that I'm an immobile Ymir if I don't get it, and it provides a good amount of HP. I mean, 300 is not something to write off immediately, because it's just a lot of HP and very cheap. But they have... Oh, that knockback! That sucks so much. Oh, he got off his ultimate. That sucks so much. Oh, man. That was so unfortunate. I went in with my blink as the Aphrodite used the knockback, which caused my freeze to be interrupted. And that is so unbelievably rough, because you can't predict something like that. You can't take that into consideration. I mean, there's no way she did that on purpose, but it worked. And oh man, otherwise I would have had a freeze, would have had a better opportunity to try and get away or just deal some damage to the enemies. But that's not the case, so we're kind of struggling in this moment. Left side Phoenix has been picked up. Can I get the Sylvanas? He's stuck in the Phoenix range. Rest in peace, Sylvanas. That wall denied him the escape out of the Phoenix range, and he took too much damage from it. Will be picked up. So that's one less healer to worry about for a bit. Let's see, can we go for something else? Looks like they want to go for the Gold Fury. Or have they already done it? I'm not sure. Wow, that Aphrodite. She is lagging so hard, that's not fair. It's also probably the best god to be lagging. Oh my god, that sucks. I think he used his escape. Nice. I definitely think he would, well, would have used his escape. It was a guess, I didn't know for sure. But, come on, can we get the Aphrodite ultimate forced? No, I can't do anything else after that. I'm not quick enough, I don't have sprint. But back to the Aokwang. I mean, Aokwang picked up the Aorama quite easily, and the only way you can really do that as an Aokwang is when you get the, well, the surprise effect. So the fact that, ooh, they also have a Frostbound, that's going to be annoying. But, oh no, I missed. No, that's going to be a lot of protection shred. I used my, that sucks. Okay, now I definitely need to get out. I'm so dead. No, please. Oh. But, I used my shell first, and after that, Nemesis used her ultimate, so she shredded actually more protections once my shell wore off, which is kind of rough. I was thinking about getting a little bit of protection, so an obsidian chart, because I have a lot of power. 336 is not too bad, but if you look at the opponents and what my team has gotten, we don't have too much healing reduction, so I'm going for some healing reduction instead. Well, we don't have as much anti-heal, only the Ra's anti-heal, and I feel like that he has, well, yeah, not too much. It's just, oh man, we don't have enough. I mean, especially if you're playing Bastet, getting a Brawler's Beatstick is mandatory. It's not even that, even if you're not against healers, Brawler's Beatstick is good on Bastet, so there's absolutely no reason, to not get it as a Bastet. So that's kind of unfortunate. She could have gotten it very, very early actually, because if you picked it up like you pick up Jotuns and afterwards you pick up Brawlers, that's a perfect synergy with your abilities. A lot of penetration works very, very well against these healers. But that's fine, I'll just pick it up myself, make sure that we have that one. That's also the main reason why I didn't go for additional health items. There are a couple of health items I could have gotten, but I feel like this will be more useful, especially since there are two healers on the opponent's side. So yeah, they are going for the fire giant, so I definitely want to make sure that we are not going to lose that one, not for free at least. Let's just head over. Looks like grass in a little bit awkward spot. I used my ultimate to provide some zoning. Sprint was used and we are able to disengage, kinda. It looks like they are going to, oh, they're going to dive and I can't move that quickly. Come on. Oh, that sucks. Couldn't really do anything after that. Come on, can I at least get the Nemesis stupid sanctuary? Oh, that sucks so much. What? Aphrodite, stop teleporting! Damn it. That is not making it any better. I mean, any other god that has lag issues like that has difficulties hitting abilities. Except for Aphrodite. Aphrodite can just be linked to someone, use their abilities, and just the teammates need to be close to the enemy for all the damage to be confirmed. So she can still be very effective whilst teleporting literally everywhere, which makes it even more difficult to kinda get this thing going. Oh well, at least we held. I mean, they didn't get the right side Phoenix, they did get the left side Phoenix again, but it was quite low. So yeah, okay, I have a power potion now, so I'm at the end of my build. I can't really improve it anymore. As for well, I can definitely improve it, but not for how I'm going to play it this time. Let's see, can we provide something? Freeze on now, Quang. Let's provide some zoning with my ultimate. I'm not going to leave Rama just to his faith, destiny, I don't know what you want to call it, but I want to try and save him if I can. No! That's very unfortunate. That ultimate hit me just as I did my carpet. But we are able to pick up Alona and the Aokwang, so that's 2-for-1, definitely worth it for us. Aphrodite teleporting away. Wow, she's so fast. I mean, Aphrodite late game is fast anyway, but she's also teleporting. Come on. At least I got a never mind. Sprint used. And she is teleporting away. Off to save the world and somewhere else. But Sylvanas is picked up, so we are able to pick up someone. Only Nemesis and Aphrodite are still alive. Do need to be a little bit careful. Don't take too much damage. I can tank for a very long time though, because of the amount of HP regen I have with the Stone of Gaia, with just the fact that we have a healer. And this is the time we need to go. If we don't attack now, I don't think we can ever win this game. So let's just go for the Titan. Let's heal up, let's tank it as long as I can. And the Titan is very low on HP. Will we be able to get it? Come on. Very close. Yes. Oh my god, I'm not sure how we won that, but I'm definitely going to. Oh my god, that was so close. I mean, they were ahead so much in kills. Their comp was just way better in, I don't know, sustaining and bursting someone into the ground. If you look at what they have, I mean, they have an Aphrodite late game, which is insanely powerful. They, well, lagging all around, but still. They have an Aokwang late game, which can deal insane damage. Nemesis late game, also insane damage. So they have a lot of hyper carries. Bellona and Sylvanas, not so much, but they still provide a lot. As for Bellona, slows, damage, crowd control with the ultimate. Sylvanas with just all his control and his healing. It's just a lot they can provide. If you look at our side, our Bastet falls off late game. Still can do a lot of damage, but late game damage falls off pretty much. If you look at the Ram, late game is actually very good. He was struggling this game, as you can see he's 3-9-6, so having a very rough time. Arbois and Ra also have very good late game. Ra will do a lot of healing, Arbois can deal a lot of damage. So I guess in that regard we had not even that much of a better late game. I think we just got lucky that we got a couple of them, were able to pick up the tower and a phoenix immediately with that. And Yeah, I think that also had a little bit to do with the fact that I could literally tank forever. I mean, I tanked that Phoenix for so much HP, and that's the only reason I can do that is because I have so much HP and regen. Anyway, it was a fun one. If you haven't tried out high HP gods, Ymir is definitely your way to go. I do recommend getting a Winged Blade and a Rod of Asclepius, or a Winged Blade and a Ritual Dagger. Those both make sure that you have enough movement speed. You will be slow immune with the Winged Blade at least once every 30 seconds and still provide health. So that's a very good one. Also very cheap. The cheapest way is just a Winged Blade Ritual Dagger. Both are 1850. So that's a very cheap combination. Provides you 500 HP and a lot of movement speed. More than boots. 2% more if I'm not mistaken. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed this one. It was a fun one. It definitely is pretty powerful. But you are, well, you don't have as much cooldowns as you usually have if you build any cooldown reduction. And if they have, for instance, a hunter with crit, they will completely shred you. So it's not like you're tanky in any way. You just have a lot of HP. That's also the reason why I picked up Shell. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any, requests, please let me know down in the comments. Can be God, can be game mode, can be builds or whatever, or combinations, of course. Thank you so much for the feedback. Hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks again so much for watching. And as always, good luck, have fun, and I'll see you guys in the next one.